Differin Gel, or Adapalene. It's the only full prescription fighting retinoid available over the counter and became available in 2016. Its active ingredient, Adapalene, has been prescribed to over 40 million people around the world for more than 20 years. How is it so popular? It clears breakouts where they start and can even prevent acne before it begins. And as a result of that, Differin Gel restores both skin texture and tone. In this video, we'll look at how to use Differin Gel to its fullest benefits and how to know if you actually need it, as well as cover 6 takeaways you should be aware of before starting. So stay tuned till the end. Hi guys, you've seen Arsalan Media Pharmacist here on YouTube. This week's video is on Differin Gel, or Adapalene Gel 0.1%. Smash the like button below now to get this video seen by more people so we can beat acne together and slow down the aging process. Differin Gel has thousands of 5-star reviews on Amazon, has 4.7 stars on CVS, and basically a near perfect score on Target's website. But what makes this acne treatment so desirable? Before I get into what it is and how to use it, let's look at 5 things you should know of first. Number 1, Adapalene is a retinoid and not a retinol. There's a difference. There are many over-the-counter retinol creams out there that are similar to retinoids, but they aren't the same. Retinol is weaker and takes longer for you to see results. Retinoids like Adapalene are much more powerful. Adapalene has a unique chemical structure that makes it less irritating on the skin than other retinoids you may have heard of, like tretinoin or retin A or isotretinoin. Adapalene comes in a 0.3% gel that is still a prescription only too. It's just basically just a stronger form. Number 2, it doesn't play well with your other acne treatments. This is why it's usually applied to at night and as a last step in your skincare routine, because products like benzoyl peroxide will actually oxidize your retinoid, making it less effective, and products like salicylic acid can lead to irritation. You should also avoid using Differin with products that contain chemical exfoliators. These include glycolic and alpha hydroxy acids, or any drying agents like astringents or toners. If you're using an exfoliator to increase that cell turnover, know that too much exfoliation can lead to raw and irritated skin. So what you could do instead is just use a moisturizer that will tone down the irritation and provide adequate hydration. I've listed ones that I highly recommend in the description below, so definitely check that out. Number 3, your skin might purge. I know that sounds a bit scary, but it's totally normal when you first start off using it. This is known as the Differin purge, or retinization. Even though it isn't a sign that the skin is actually getting worse, it may be alarming to some. Some may even stop applying it because they're convinced it made their acne worse. But think of it as an adjustment period in which the skin is getting used to the retinoid. During the second week or so, your skin may become irritated, causing dryness, scaling, redness, and even burning. This usually will end up getting cleared out on its own once all the blockages lurking beneath the surface have been cleared out and your skin starts off new again. So in the meantime, keep moisturizing and wear an SPF sunscreen during the daytime until the purge is over. I have a video on which SPF you should be using, so click up here to find out. Number 4, it's known in the skincare community as an anti-ager, and this is because it has helped others with improvement of fine lines, wrinkles, and pigmentation. Number 5, it's not for everyone. The FDA advises that women who are pregnant, trying to get pregnant, or breastfeeding not to use Differin. Also, if you have ultra-sensitive skin, dermatitis, or eczema, it's best to avoid using it altogether. Now let's get into actually how to use it. Differin Gel is meant for once daily use, even when you see no signs of acne, because it's designed to prevent acne from coming on. This is why it's not recommended as a spot treatment to treat a single pimple. So if you get acne on the face, the gel should be applied to the entire face, not just one spot alone. So to start off, take a pea-sized amount and spread it thinly across the affected area until it has become fully absorbed. What works for some is to apply it during the evening, before getting to bed, and after you have already showered. Make sure you apply it onto a dry face and not a wet face, as this can cause irritation. And a pro tip is to be consistent, apply it once a day, every day, and at the same time of day. Make sure to avoid the eyes, lips, and any more mucous membranes. Also know that your skin may get more sensitive to UV light, so take steps to avoid unprotected sun exposure. A big question, obviously, with using Differin is, when will I see results? In one clinical study, patients reported up to an 87% decrease in acne after 12 weeks of use, which to me is awesome. Check out the hashtag Do Things Differin and Differin Challenge to see 12-week journeys of others. I hope this video was useful to you guys, and I hope that you do share it with someone you know who could benefit from it. Like the video if you did enjoy it, and subscribe to stay on board with all my other weekly health and wellness videos. Thanks for sticking tuned all the way till the end, and as always, thanks for watching.